the flames were shooting up and outward, and it just spread throughout the living room, and the heat just got worse and worse.
Well, I was operating on patrol in the gang enforcement detail in the area of Jay in Washington when I observed smoke coming from a building not too far from me. So I made an approach to check if there was occupants. And as I approached, there was a female standing behind a wrought iron gate, and I was unable to open the door. So at that point, what I did is I got on the radio again, asked for a code red and additional units and some type of breaching tool.
I could see the flames on the roof from the other side of the buildings or the houses.
When I got in my car, I got information that there was possibly another subject trapped in the back.
And I could hear the female screaming inside.
I ran up to the door and I tried to grab the door and pull on it, and I ended up burning my hand. While I was doing that, Detective Prager ran to the trunk of the vehicle and he retrieved these bolt cutters. We were then able to get the bars bent out of the way and reach in and pick her up and pull her out through the door as the flames were making it to the front of the house. It was then that Detective Prager and myself got her by the arms and the legs and carried her through the front yard and down the street to an awaiting ambulance.
It was definitely gratifying. Like I said, it's the screams of somebody burning is something I'll never forget.
For me, it felt excellent. It was a good feeling. I had been in a situation like that before where we lost victims.
At a certain point, you're willing to risk your safety for others.
Anybody in my position on this job would have done the same exact thing. It just happened to be that at that night, at that time, we were in the right place at the right time, and Detective Prager had the right tool for the job that night.
She was in grave danger. If we wouldn't have been able to get her out, she wouldn't have made it. She would not have made it.